Today we're going to pull the motor out of my 6.4 Ford and put in a 5.9. This is the second time the 6.4 has been blown up. So you start by pulling out both batteries, and then you go back and you remove the battery boxes. There's usually two bolts in the bottom and a couple bolts in the side. Make sure you've drained your coolant. Save it, because it's expensive. Also drain your power steering fluid as well. Next, what you want to do is you want to pull out, there's three sensors on your master cylinder. Once you've pulled out your battery box, you can get at them. Then there's two bolts, well, nuts, that hold the master cylinder to the frame. Don't unhook the brake lines. Just slide the master cylinder ahead gently once you've unhooked it. And it stays with the truck. So when you're raising the body off the frame, just stick it on the side of the motor with a zip tie so it doesn't fall over and break. Once you pull the master cylinder away, you can get at the steering connection. It's just a simple bolt. You undo it, you tap it back with a hammer. And then there's two lines that run to your power steering pump. Those lines unhook and they stay with the truck. Next, you want to remove the data cable. It's just a simple latch plug. Then you go over to the passenger side. You're going to have to remove the air box, the air filter, undo the AC sensor, move it out of the way. Next, you need to unhook the grounds, and the one round wire is the starter wire. And this remove all the other power lines that go across the frame. There's also two vacuum lines that you want to make sure you know where they go. One will go down to your tire and the other one goes back across the frame. Now you want to unhook your alternator plug. Be careful with that because you want to use this alternator on your Dodge. There's just a simple bracket you can pick up and use the same alternator. They say the computer seems to like it better. So remember, there's just two plugs and pull them out. Then unhook the data cables from the passenger side. Again, they're just those latch plugs. Slide them back and pull them out. Try not to get any dirt. Now you go underneath the truck and unhook the clip for the transmission. It's a little plastic clip. Slide it off and then put it back on so you don't lose the little plastic clip. And then remove it from the bracket. Next, you go back to your emergency brake cable. You just open it up a bit and pull it back through the frame. If not, when you go to raise the body up, it'll pull it right through and make an awful mess. Next, unhook your coolant for your transmission on both sides because the rads all go up with the body. Raise the cab off. I raise it up slowly just to make sure you haven't missed anything. Usually a ground wire or ground strap. And once you've got her raised up, owner vehicle. You can see the Dodge is all rusted out, but the 24 valve is beautiful inside. So we've pulled off the exhaust manifold, and then we got to put on the other manifold, which takes the turbo and puts it down lower so it doesn't hit the AC on the F-350. So I've got the turbo pulled off here, and this is a new manifold here, so it's upside down compared to the other one. So now I'm just going to finish cleaning this motor up. I'm going to paint the block, make it all look special. Also, we have to take off the alternator. And I've got another alternator bracket to put on so we can use the Ford alternator. Motor mounts on both sides of the engine. You have to use the front holes, not the back holes. Towards the back of the engine, you want to use the front holes. And then we put on the timing gear on the front. This goes right ahead of the balancer, and then the two bolts, and then the sensor. We left the sensor off because there has to be a certain gap that goes in here to make sure everything spins freely. That adapter plate, you have to grind part of this block away so this hole lines up, so your starter, when you stick your starter in, it clears it, because we're using the starter out of the Ford. So it bolts right there.
This is a good time to change the rear main seal.
Starter on, then I came around, bolted on the flywheel and the torque converter. Getting closer. Next, I'm going to stick the new intake or exhaust manifold on in the turbo. I'm going to stick the motor in. The problem we've got is that the oil pan is pretty tight to that front cross member. As you can see, everything seems to be fitting all right. And our motor mount's installed. So you can see them there, so they're just going to sit right on the frame. And what I did with the transmission cooler lines is I just turned them up out of the way till I get it, figured out where I'm going to put them, and then stick them in. But this is the part I was talking about, where the oil pan and the frame are. Should fit. So we got the front end tipped down just a little bit to take that angle, and it should just slip right in. Motor mounts are sitting on the frame. We've tilted the hoist back the opposite way now to let the ass end of the motor down to bring the front up a bit so the shafts line up. We also unbolted the transmission at the back and blocked it underneath and raised it up about, well, 2x4. And that lined the whole drive line up. So she should just slide right back together. I've used the 5.9 air conditioning pump. It bolted right up. I took the end off the air conditioning pump, off the 5.9, and then I soldered, well, aluminum welded, as you can see here, the two lines from the F-350 Ford back onto it. So I'm using the Dodge air conditioning pump with the Ford air conditioning lines back to the Ford air conditioner to make it work. And the guys at Diesel Conversions put the end on for me, so it plugs right into my air conditioning pump and life's good. So that's what it looks like with my AC lines hooked up. And they're ready to go. And the good thing about it is the high pressure switch stayed on the line, on the forward line, and is plugged back in. The oil pressure sensor that you're going to need is down on top of the engine, right down in by the oil filter, which is that little guy right down here. You just spin them out. I loosened them up already, so just spin them out. Just a little sensor like that, single pole, and it goes in the top of the 5.9 oil filter. So there's the oil filter, and that's the little hole that we got to fill. So I got a little bushing that fits the metric tapered angle to the sensor, so it should screw in quite easily. tighten her up and click the sensor on, and all will be good. And it clears our manifolds, and it just plugs in to our existing wiring. Now I got my wiring harness, like I mentioned this earlier, from Diesel Conversion Specialist. I sent them my old wiring harness and my new wiring harness off the Ford and off the Dodge, and they put it all together. And how awesome is that, that they labeled all the parts where everything goes. So the thing I made up today was, the next thing was the turbo for the intercooler. And the intercooler I just took off right now so I could flush it. And what I used for the intercooler was just simple exhaust pipe.
So I used the Dodge turbo pipes and turbo boots and just cut them off and made them fit the Ford intercooler. It worked pretty good.
So this is the back of the power steering pump of the 5.9 Dodge. It bolted right on. The thing about this though, it has, this is a return line, and this is the other return line that I've cut off. And I'm going to join those together in a block, and this is the main pressure line. So what I'm doing with the main pressure line is I'm just taking the end off of it and I'm splicing in the end off of the Ford. Well, you can see it here. Off the Ford, I just cut it and I'll just put a pressure connector on and join that back to the line. And then the return lines I'm going to stick together in a block such as that. While you're taking parts and sensors off, you're going to need the mass airflow sensor, which is down here. There's two of them. This one goes on the intake side, and we'll pull this one out. Like, this is right off your turbo on that tube, and this is the one that's going to go on the air horn. So just so you see for reference on the 6.7 or the 6.4, that's where it is.
I purchased a new air horn. This is where the mass airflow sensor from the 6.4 goes in. I use the existing throttle linkage, and I just cut a hole through the firewall, and then went and purchased a Ford pedal from the wrecking yard, and it seemed to work pretty good. This is just an image of the passenger side. You can see where the rad hose is going to come out of the bottom. I used all the existing rad pieces from the 6.4 and just cut them to suit because I used the existing rad. The air conditioner lines just pulled up, bent out of the way. You can see the alternator bracket, and you can see the 6.4 starter. Also on the top, I used the transmission and the temperature sensor, and I stuck them out of the two ports out of the top of the block. As long as these two sensors are reading the same temperature, it'll trick your computer and everything will work fine. So I use the existing intercooler pipe from the 6.4, and I added a couple pieces of 3-inch exhaust pipe just to make the bends, and then I welded them all together to make the intercooler pipe. I fastened the PCs to the firewall, and the ECM remained on the block. I didn't hook up the cruise control, but that's an easy thing to do if you want in your spare time. But I did use Diesel Conversion for programming the transmission. They sent me a couple files that work really good. I don't recommend you driving the truck without reprogramming the transmission first. But if you have any questions, drop me a line. I've put a bunch of other resources together for anybody wishing to do this project.